All right. Back to work tonight, guys and gals. Thursday evening, after all. October the 1st, 2020. My name is Joseph. And as always, welcome back to your nightly newsletter. Now, if you're watching for the first time tonight, my job tonight is to help us find the best trade setups for tomorrow. That's Friday. No, not any Friday. Non-farm Friday's trading session. And I got a great video in store for you guys and gals tonight. Charts are all prepped up in the background, as you can see. Got a lot of great setups we're tracking for tomorrow. Got the oil, got the gold, and got the E-minis on our radar for tomorrow's non-farm Friday. Before we jump in and get our hands dirty on the best setups I'm watching to finish up the week here tomorrow morning, I just want to make sure to remind you guys to make sure you subscribe to this YouTube channel. If you haven't done so already, make sure you subscribe to the channel. That way you always get the good stuff delivered right to your inbox. And don't forget, if you have any questions for me tonight, drop those questions in the comment section below. And as always, I really appreciate you guys tuning in every evening to watch this video. If you love this video as much as I enjoy creating this for you guys every evening, hit that thumbs up button for me tonight on the nightly newsletter. So again, don't forget to subscribe. That way you get the good stuff every evening. Drop those questions in the comment section below. And if you like the content, thumbs up here for us here tonight on the nightly newsletter. But enough of the introduction. Time is ticking. I'm a bit behind schedule. Let's get this video started by checking out the calendar for tomorrow. Now, of course, tomorrow we wrap up what is really the first couple days here of a brand new month. Now, we've been talking about this pretty much all week here this week, right? End of the quarter, end of the month, right? Now we're into a new quarter and a new month. So we do anticipate volatility levels to be a little bit higher than normal, right? We will start to see that subside next week as we go into the markets. Remember, that week where we transition from 1 month to the next, in this case, 1 quarter to the next year, end of month, new month transitions, we do expect there to be increased volatility during this time. Tomorrow, of course, being the end of the week, not the end of the month, end of the week, though, we do know Fridays, right? What's the overall strategy for a Friday? Early in, early out, right? Don't hit that snooze button too much tomorrow morning. Make sure you get to your desk bright and early, because the window of opportunity on a Friday morning is a lot smaller. You know, we usually look for trades in our trade room all the way through to about 11:30 Eastern time. But I'll tell you right now, on a Friday morning, especially a non-farm Friday, you've really got to have a good reason to be trading after 11 o'clock Eastern time. We get together every morning in our trade room. We begin looking for setups at 8 o'clock, right? And we usually go till about 11:15, 11:30. But again, tomorrow being a Friday, keep your eyes on the time. And really, as of about maybe 10:45 a.m., you want to start really kind of thinking about, right, scaling things back and really paying attention to the kind of the health of the price action, right? When price action starts to slow down, we start seeing ranges widen out, ATR starts to tick higher. That's usually your sign it's time to wrap things up for the weekend. Now, of course, looking deeper into the session tomorrow, everything is really pinned to this employment number tomorrow morning, right? That is the big news for tomorrow. Now, keep in mind, we saw a very positive ADP number on Wednesday morning. It was almost twice as many jobs added as they were expecting. And what that means for us on Friday morning, tomorrow morning, is the bar has been set very high for this employment number. You know, again, as we always talk about, right, that employment number, that non-farm Friday employment number, it's the first Friday of the week. Well, that Wednesday before is the ADP employment report. Now, why do we care about that employment report? Because that's used as a reference to what we get on Friday. So, for example, right, the ADP number on Wednesday came out, again, almost double what they were expecting. That sets the bar very high now for that employment number. You could also argue that gold, the S&P, right, oil has already priced in a lot of those, right, a lot of that ADP number. So think about it. The markets right now, especially the gold, especially the S&P, these markets, they're lofty right now. We'll take a look at the charts in a moment. That is all because of the employment situation that's been priced in ahead of time, right? Traders see that big number on Wednesday, right, and base the markets price in that expectation of a higher number into Friday. The bottom line is, the biggest point I want to make is that I think everybody, the analysts, traders, are anticipating a really strong number for tomorrow. And the reason why that's important, if we get anything within expectations, don't expect much. Now, hopefully I'm wrong, but usually when the employment number comes out right on target within expectation ranges, usually we see trading ranges, sideways movement, right? We don't usually get a lot of volatility. The big opportunity tomorrow, though, from what I would assume, is if that number comes out under expectations, right? Because remember, the markets today have already priced in what they've anticipated was a good number since Wednesday, right? We've seen the gold's gone higher, E-minis have gone higher. So what I'm really paying attention to tomorrow is, does that number come out lower, right? Does this number really come out as a big miss? If that happens, that's where I see some of the biggest, possibly a big sell-off, but really the biggest opportunities are probably going to come. So that's kind of where I'm going tomorrow, or what I'm anticipating here with the employment number. Now remember, if it comes out within expectations, we're probably gonna see a little bit of chop and sideways movement, so you gotta give it some time after that number comes out. But be aware, if that number surprises people, that's where things could really get bloody tomorrow, right? Good or bad, really, right? Big positive number, right? Big negative number. That's where things get exciting here in the wake of that 8:30 employment report. Now, if you're in Asia, if you're in London, or you're in Europe, if you're trading before that news comes out, don't force it here overnight. I know it's end of month or new month and volatility should be here, but I think we all saw, right? Things got pretty slow late in the day today. And as I mentioned in last night's newsletter, you got to remember the big traders in the market, the people who actually provide liquidity for all of us day traders, they are forced on the sidelines right now, right? If you were managing a big chunk of capital, right, I realize that we're all day traders, right? We trade our own money here. But the reality is, if you're working for a big trading firm, your boss would be breathing down your neck right now, making sure you don't mess this thing up before that employment number comes out. So big lot traders, big position traders, right, big trading firms, they're keeping it small ahead of that news number tomorrow, because the potential for a huge move, right, is so significant. So be careful overnight. Don't force it. If it's moving slowly, you know why. Now, a lot of times we will see pretty good activity in the lead up to that employment number. So, you know, again, sometimes very slow, sometimes very busy. But my big thing is just be careful. Don't force it overnight. If things aren't moving quickly, if they're not moving consistently, stay away. You know they're waiting for that employment number. And then again, do we come out within expectations tomorrow? If that's the case, expect some ranges. If we don't, that's where the big opportunity is. I'm looking for either a big up number or a big down number. That's where I see the big fireworks and potentially some of the biggest setups we may get as we go into the weekend. Now, don't forget, guys, we'll be in our trade room every morning, Monday through Friday, 8 o'clock Eastern time. Have a front row seat, that employment number, right, every morning. I'll put all the links you guys need to get registered as a brand new member and come out and join us in the trade room. I'll put all the trade room links you guys need in the description of the YouTube video. Get registered and come out and trade this stuff with us every morning at the opening bell. Employment number tomorrow, non-farm number tomorrow, early in, early out. I would be lying to you if I said I wasn't quite curious how that number is going to look tomorrow morning. Let's grab some charts here now. Charts are all prepped up in the background, as you can see. Got the S&P, we got the oil, and we got the gold. What will these markets give us here for tomorrow? Well, first of all, taking a look at the gold right now. Gold is a bull market into a narrow, narrow trading range. I've got two really nice support levels here on gold I'm watching. I got two different entry setups I'm watching for on the gold. We'll take a look at that here in a moment. Over on the oil, big move down. Is it fair to say we nailed that blow off top last night on the oil, right? Oil makes a big move down. It's a bear flag on oil. Bear flags are all about traps, and we'll talk about traps and kind of how to anticipate and avoid getting trapped, how to capitalize on traps on crude oil. So you definitely want to stay tuned for more on that. And then over here on the E-mini, boy, the E-mini has a lot of conflicting signals right now. Bulls have it, Bears have it. The E-mini, Mark, you can tell. You can tell something's coming, right? You can tell something's coming because the E-mini looks like it just looks like it's walking on eggshells right now. And that's expected ahead of this big non-farm payroll number here tomorrow morning. So what do we know about the E-mini right now? We get a bunch of basically conflicting signals. There's a bit of an identity crisis going on right now on this E-mini. The first thing we notice is, right, that big gap up, right? That big run going higher. Now, you would think that anytime we see that much strength in one direction, they're going to pull it back and they're going to retest the high. But you'll notice they didn't. What happened was the market sinks lower and goes into a trading range. So from my point of view, I see this being a bull spike. The buyers have one thing on their mind. They want to retest those highs. Right, so buyers definitely have momentum at their back on that. But again, look at the range though. It's a bear market into a trading range. And again, in all reality, very difficult to pin down who really has control of this market. I'm leaning on the sell side. I'm leaning towards the sell side just because of that bear move down into that trading range. I've also got that gap down there, and I think we might see a surprise from that non-farm payroll number tomorrow. I don't know though. I'm making an educated guess there. So get the gap below us. I'm leaning on the sell side right now. But again, as you can see, very much conflicting signals as we go into Friday's trading session. You could easily draw a trend line right off of those lows, and all of a sudden this becomes a triangle, right? So it's very consolidated, wound up nice and tight into this trading range, and the range has a bear bias to it. Now, what do we do with a bear bias into a trading range? Because that's pretty much the most important clue as far as structuring our trades here. Now, we talk about this quite a bit on this newsletter, right? There are three basic patterns I like to look for whenever I have a bear market into a trading range, right? So bear market into a trading range, three basic patterns, right? The most reliable way to trade a bear market into a trading range is to look for what I call failure patterns above the high of the range. I want to sell above the high of that range. The directional bias tells me use the range as a magnet. Right? Use the range as a magnet. And what I'll try to wait for the price to go up. I like to wait for the buyers to come in and try to buy a pullback. I don't try to pick a top up here, right? I don't try to mess around with picking a top up here. It's very difficult to pick tops and bottoms. What I'd rather do is wait for that pop up, wait for those buyers to try to buy the pullback. Now it's much easier. Now I know where their stops are and I can sell right into those stop losses. We call those failure patterns. It's called a two-try failure pattern, and we love those patterns in our trade room. Bear market, use the range as a magnet, right? So that's one way to do it, right? Is a buyer failure pattern, selling above the high of the range. There are two more patterns though, two more breakout patterns. You ready for them? We've talked about these quite a bit, but I'm sure if you're here for the first time though, this will help you out for tomorrow. One breakout pattern is called a 1-2-3 breakdown. You want a strong move below the range, a pullback to the moving average, and a jump off the moving average, right? People always ask me, at what point does a breakout become a breakout, right? At what point can we start trading in that new trend? Once we see that 1-2-3 breakout down, mark that low now, mark that high, and I can get short off the high of that hidden channel, right? That's one breakout. The second breakout is called the two-try breakout. This one requires a very strong move down, right? That first one doesn't require a big strong move. It requires a strong jump off the moving average, but does not require a very strong first leg. This second breakout pattern called the two-try breakout requires a very strong breakdown. Then what I'm looking for is a shallow pullback, a lower low, and a trap high for the entry. So these are the three patterns I'm looking forward to tomorrow, right, to use this trading range. Again, it's a buyer failure pattern above the range. It is a 1-2-3 breakout pattern below the range, or a 2-try breakout pattern below that trading range. When I go back to my chart now, you can see there's my trading range. What I want to do is I want to find a level of resistance above the range, such as that trend line, such as this hidden channel trend line, such as this swing high line, right? This whole area up here really makes for great areas of resistance. What I'd like to do is, if I had it my way tomorrow, I'd like to get us up into that trend line, get those buyers coming over, get them to take the bait and try to buy into that high. What a horrible place, right, to be buying at that point, right, up around those highs. And hopefully we get a chance to trade right into those stop losses and sell the sucker back down to retest the low. A buyer failure pattern up above the top of that trading range. The next, of course, with the breakout patterns, right? Those breakout patterns, now again, remember, it's not enough to just see a strong move down. We saw a strong move right there, right? That strong move has to hold that pullback and jump. If I can get that strong move lower, if they can hold that pullback and jump off the moving average, well, now I have a 1-2-3 breakout pattern. At that point now, momentum is for the bears. We've broken free of the magnetic field of that trading range. I'm going to mark up that low. I'm going to mark up that high, find that hidden channel. And I always like to go after the first test of that hidden channel. 1-2-3 breakout pattern, 1 strong move down, 2 pull back, 3 right jump off the moving average into the first test of the high of that channel. Now, 2 try breakout, strong move down, right? This one's got to be a very strong move down, shallow pullback, usually barely touches the moving average, lower low in price, then that trap high. Right? That's the good stuff right there. So 3 setups I'm watching for here. And again, the big variable on this, obviously, is that non-farm payroll report, right? Will it come out tomorrow morning and will the market go sideways here? If we go sideways and keep going sideways, nothing changes. Get me up, buyer failure, back down. Get me down, 1-2-3 breakdown, right? 1-2 trap breakout. Same patterns if this market goes sideways here. And I wouldn't be surprised if it does with that big news coming out tomorrow morning at 8:30 Eastern time. Now, how about a buy side, right? How do we buy this market? Very, very possible that number tomorrow will come out pretty good, right? Because again, we heard the ADP report early this week, and the number surprised a lot of folks here. So where do we think these buyers might be trying to go to? I've got a measured move level up at that 34.22, right? Got a measured move level up around that 34.22 area. You'll notice if you connect some of these levels here, right, 1-2, right, that 34.22. That's where I would anticipate these buyers in the short term are trying to go, right? Sellers, of course, they want to get down to refill that weekend gap at 85.5, right? So if bears take control, we know where they're trying to go, right, down to retest those lows. But again, how do I buy this market right now? There's really 2 ways to buy it. And of course, the range is the most important factor in it. So we know where they're trying to go here now for the bull side. How can I buy underneath the range? Can I buy underneath the range? I definitely can. I want to make sure if I'm buying, though, I want to buy at a support level, right? Either that swing at 50.5 or that trend line, right? And when it comes to ranges, buy low, sell high, use that range as a magnet. That's why we go up. We look to sell it back down again. Now, if we go down, though, here's the problem. We're bearish. Right? We're very bearish, right? That momentum will feel very bearish when we go lower here. I want to be a buyer off that low. Well, I can be. What would be the best way to buy it, though? If we run lower here, what I can do is I'll use a slight variation of that failure pattern. I want to get the bears to try it twice. Let them try it once, go higher high. I like to draw a trend line off of that low. Let them try twice, right, and buy into those stop losses. Now you can see there's a big difference between that, what I call a nested failure pattern. Again, right, bears trying once, bears trying twice. There's a big difference there between that 1-2-3 reversal, right? So don't confuse these. I'm looking to buy off of that low. If all we get is that strong move down, bears try once, bears try twice, we'll have to buy this sucker going back up into that trading range. How do we buy as the market goes higher? Those breakout patterns are still the same, pretty much the same breakout patterns. Strong move up, hold the pullback, jump off the moving average, right? 1-2-3 breakout, mark up that high, mark up that low. We know where we're trying to get long here now, right, with that 1-2-3 breakout pattern into that hidden channel pullback. How about a 2-try breakout? Easy, strong move up, shallow pullback, right? Strong move up, shallow pull back to the moving average, higher high in price, trap low, and we're in from there, right? So pretty simple idea here. The only adjustment, of course, is that nested failure, right, around the low of this range, just because the overall momentum, right, momentum is so bearish. But the breakout patterns will be the breakout patterns, right? 1, 2, 3 breakout, or 2 try breakout pattern as we go higher. Now, I'll tell you guys, we talk all about failure patterns and breakout patterns in our free trading courses. So don't forget, we're going to trade this stuff together every morning in our trade room. But if you can't be with me tomorrow morning and every morning in the trade room, don't forget to grab our free trading classes. That way, at the very least, you can learn all my favorite setups, learn my 3-step strategy. That little pop-up there in the upper right-hand corner, grab that link, just popped up there. Register for the free trading classes. That way, you can make the most of our time together in the next, right, in our next edition, right, of our nightly newsletter. So grab that link, get registered for the free trading course. That way you can learn the setups, get a deeper dive into all of them, and you're ready for the newsletter, you're ready to capitalize on these opportunities, and also to be ready for a trade room action with us every morning at the opening bell. All right, we're looking good. The only question I have right now is, what's the news going to look like? How will the market react to that news? Be careful here overnight, right? And watch for the right setups. Let's keep going here. Got the S&P looking good. How about some oil? Looking at the oil, boy, we talked about that blow-off top last night, right? Talk about that blow-off top. That blow-off top, right, came back once, twice, right? And I warned you guys, look for those traps, right? Trap pattern for the short, right? Trap pattern for the short. 1, 2, 3, break down for the short. I mean, you didn't have to work that hard if you tuned in last night's newsletter, be ready to capitalize on that oil. Most important thing right now, what do we see? It's pretty much a flag. We have a bear market down, very strong move. Anytime we see a strong move in one direction, what do we expect? We expect to see a retest of that low and potentially, right, another leg lower, which in this case could go as far if we look left here. You got that 36.41 area, right? So if these bears keep this thing going here, 36.41, 35, big round number, right? Get some easy targets down there at 36 and change, right, for these bears. Big strong move down says we should expect at the very least a retest of that low. At the very most, another symmetrical leg going lower here. You'll notice, though, this one big problem, though. It looks like these bulls have got their hook into this thing. This is not a bull market yet. You can just tell by the way it's holding above the moving average right now. It's a flag pattern. It's a flag. Flag patterns are very common whenever we see a very big move down like this. The reality is nobody wants to sell low. So the market kind of grinds its way higher, slowly grinds its way higher. That creates what looks to be like a bull channel. And it's usually one of the bigger, most confusing kind of patterns for new traders because it looks like it's bullish. But make no mistake, all of that momentum right now will likely carry this thing back down to retest the low. So the best way to trade a flag pattern is to anticipate the buyers in the market thinking this is a bull market and trade into their stops. And the best pattern to do that is a trap pattern. Now, we know we're bearish, right? We know we're bearish. So ideally, I want to find a level of resistance up top that I can sell off of. So you'll see that 3890 level. This 3890 level, if you go all the way back, what is that, from the 21st of September, that area, 3890, is a great area of resistance. That would be kind of the dream come true for those sellers. At the same time, I'm anticipating if I was a buyer, where would I be looking to get long? If I was a buyer, I'd be looking to get long at the low of this hidden channel, right? I would draw this trend line off these highs. I would bring it down to that low. And if I was a buyer, I'd be looking to get that little trap, right, off of that low. Almost looks like that 2-try trap pattern that we talked about a few moments ago, right? So that would be if I was a buyer, that's where I'd be looking to get long. And for all I know, they might hold it, right? They could easily hold it, especially with news coming out tomorrow. But right now, though, we're not a bull market. If they do hold that pullback, let's be honest, if they do hold that pullback and run, well, now we have a 1-2-3 reversal. We can mark up that new hidden channel, and now we can buy that next pullback. But we're not quite there yet, right? We're not quite there yet. So what's the best way to do this? There's really two ways to look at this. One would be we go up, and here's the problem. If we go higher, buyers are going to try. They're going to probably try a couple times to buy the pullbacks. So to capitalize on this, knowing that I'll probably have a trend line here, I'm going to look for traps, right? One try for the bulls, two try for the bulls, that trap high. Again, like I said, when it comes to flag patterns, you want to get focused on traps. We're trying to be a seller because we're trying to go back down to retest that low at 37.62. And again, bull trap, right? That's one setup for tomorrow. Another one would be as we go lower, one try for the bulls, two try for the bulls, trap high, right? Anticipate that buyers will be coming in trying to anticipate their own channel here, right? Get ahead of it here and sell into those stop losses. Now, there's one more potential setup. Sometimes what happens is the market collapses back down. If the market collapses back down, your job is to wait to get up and use some of these resistance levels as your entry. Okay, this is probably the hardest entry for a flag pattern. What's going to happen is, in this scenario, is the market will take off the downside and the rookies will get roped into selling down here. But the reality is, trying to sell there, your risk-reward ratio is horrible because the objective is to retest that 62 low. Professionals are not going to want to sell down into those lows. What they'll probably do is they'll wait for it to kind of give you like a breakout pullback. You know what I mean? Like there is your support trend line, right? Support trend line. Think about it this way. Goes down, nobody wants to sell low, whoop, come back up and hit it from there. That's the general idea of if the market collapses down. Again, what I'd like to get is, I'd like to get us up and then one try, two try, trap, and back down again. That would be kind of the dream come true. Very similar, right, to what we saw there, where they went up, right, one, two, exactly as we talked about it last night on the newsletter. Same basic idea for tomorrow. Or do we go lower? One try for the bulls, two try for the bulls, and trap. Again, traps are what you want to use on this because it feels so bullish, right? Again, this is obviously a big picture chart, right? But in the short term, though, a lot of buyers are going to see this channel and they're going to want to buy that pullback, right? They're going to want to buy that pullback. We have to anticipate that, play it against them, let them try once, let them try twice, and hit them right where it hurts. The hardest one is if the market just dumps. Right. If it dumps, what you want to do is start to look for, okay, where can I get resistance? Sometimes we get like one of these where it'll bounce and come down again, right? Draw the trend line, draw that reversal line, and then hit it up in there. You know what I mean? It's the same idea. It's one try for the bulls. It's two try for the bulls. It's just if the market sinks too low, we don't want to chase after it. We want to wait for that pop. Right, wait for that pop and selling into, right, all the pops right here on this oil. Flag patterns can be tricky because, again, a lot of people will see this bull channel and they're not going to give up easily, right? They'll try a couple times down here. That's why you want to sell high, right? You don't want to sell low because buyers will try to come in and hit it. Now, this could also get pretty ugly here for the bears if this thing runs lower, holds the pullback, right, and jumps off the moving average. What is that? It's a 1-2-3 breakdown, basically, right? It's a 1-2-3 move. At that point now, if it runs through those lows, now we know they're hunting for those low 36s. Mark up that low, mark up that high. If we have enough strength on this 1-2-3, again, kind of 1-2-3 breakdown, enough strength, those lows, I'll have no problem using those lows as resistance, right, or any bit lower than those lows on the chart. So keep that in mind if the market does collapse as we go lower. And again, that 36, right, that 36.41 level, right, is ideally where these bears will be hunting for. So if they can get enough strength going lower here, we definitely may have ourselves a pretty good run for those bears. Now, I touched on the bull side here earlier. The bull side is all about patience right now. Right, the bear side is all about traps and trying to catch those buyers, trying to get greedy. Right, the bull side is all about patience. Again, if you want to get aggressive, you're more than welcome to. If you want to get aggressive on this, you've got that two try trap, right? I just don't think this momentum, this big bear move down, I'm not about to trade against that yet until we start seeing these buyers actually put their money in play and hold this stuff. But again, if the buyers can hold that pullback and jump, well, perfect. Now I can mark up that high, I can mark up that low, and I can buy the pullback right off of that low. If I clean off this kind of hidden channel there real quickly here, right? So imagine now we do get that trap low, the market runs higher, right? Mark up that high, mark up that low, and look for what I call a failure into a pullback combination. It's a failure pattern into a pullback pattern off the low of that hidden channel, right? So again, 1, 2, 3 reversal, right? Seller failure, wait for those bears to get below the moving average. It's a bull market at that point. Wait for those bears to get below the moving average, buy right into their stop losses, and then of course, right, buying the pullback to the moving average from there. Where's our objective? Our objective is gonna be that 40-47. We may end up getting stuck in the mud a bit around 40, but if you have an extra contract, definitely want to leave that runner up for that retest of that 40-47. Now, one more pattern I'm always watching for on reversals are those two try traps. Keep your eyes open for this. These are very common, right? Again, we see a 1-2-3 reversal. We see that shallow pullback, and what you can do is you can combine that trap along with the low of that channel. Does that make sense, right? So two try trap at the low of that channel as well. So keep your eyes open on those. And you know, one thing I have in my notes here that I do want to mention too is be prepared tomorrow to finish the session in range tomorrow, right? So at some point tomorrow morning, the market will probably go sideways. And the reason for that is that big move today. Usually when you have a big move in one day, the following day is a trading range. Now, what's probably likely to happen is we're likely to go back down to retest that low and then come back in and start going sideways right from there. You know what I mean? We're likely to get what we want, but then we'll start going sideways. Or maybe we go higher here and start going sideways around that 40. But be aware, you do want to anticipate, because of that big move down today, you do want to anticipate some range bound markets here for tomorrow. So bull traps to get short, wait for that 1-2-3 reversal to get long. And again, will we collapse back down to that 36.41 with that 1-2-3 move going lower? I don't want to sell, right? Again, if it collapses down, pop it up, find that resistance, right? And short it before we get down there. If the market runs 1-2-3, okay, don't chase it. Mark that low, mark that high, right? And we're selling off of that high. Looking forward to a great session tomorrow morning, right, on the oil. Let's keep going. How am I doing so far? Any questions for me so far? Don't forget, any questions, drop those questions in the comment section below. And how about a thumbs up button for me here tonight? Hopefully you're still watching, tuning in here every evening. And I assume by now you subscribed to our YouTube channel. How about some gold here? Let's wrap things up with a yellow metal. Now I will warn you, out of all the markets we're talking about tonight, gold is probably the most difficult as we go into non-farm Friday. Hopefully I'm wrong, right? Sometimes we do see some pretty good price action on the gold ahead of non-farm payrolls, but just please be careful tomorrow. Gold has the potential to really be a nasty market on any of the big news events, you know, FOMC, non-farm payrolls, things like that. So, you know, be aware of that. Now, on the gold, I want to zoom out a little bit here, because it's important that you see where we are, right? We're right on top of that big range, not from this week, but from last week, right? That was what, back on the 22nd. So yeah, it was what? Yeah, a week ago, right? Back a week ago, right? So a week and a half ago, back here on the 21st, 22nd. That trading range will probably act as a magnet, unless, of course, you know, again, the big variable for tomorrow is that big non-farm payroll report. So I want to make sure you guys see where we are kind of in the big picture on this, because that's going to give us it gives us some knowledge as far as how the market will probably play out, right? Unless, of course, this thing gets whacked by some big news report tomorrow morning at 8:30 Eastern time. Again, if the number comes out better or worse, preferably, I'm almost hoping the number comes out really bad tomorrow. But obviously, for the health of the economy, obviously, I hope it does come out right very positive. But again, I think the big opportunity tomorrow, especially on gold, will be if the number does come out a lot lower than they had expected, just because everybody's expecting such a rosy number. So we're back into this big range, right? And you'll notice here right away, we're also bullish into a trading range right now. Right now, we talked about the plan to sell with a bear range, right? Let's talk quickly about this one now. If I have a bull market into a trading range, what's the plan? There are three basic patterns, right? Same patterns, but different direction. I want to buy underneath the range, use that range as a magnet. I'll wait for the price to go lower. I'll wait for that break down, right? Let the bears try to get short off the moving average, right? Basically wait for a breakout pullback pattern and then trade right into those stops. That's my favorite way to trade breakouts. I trade against breakouts, right? Trust me, when I was a rookie, I used to love breakouts, but my money kept running out of my account, right? That's the reality. You lose too much money trading breakouts, especially in liquid markets, right? You know, illiquid markets, breakouts might work, penny stocks, cryptos, you know, things like that, but that stuff's pretty much just gambling, right? We're trading liquid markets. Liquid markets ranges act like a magnet. So I want to use a failure pattern to buy below the low of that trading range. Then what was that? What were those two breakout patterns? The first one was a 1-2-3 breakout going higher, right? Strong move up, hold the pullback, jump off the moving average, mark that high, right? Mark that low, and we're buying off that low. Or it's a strong move up, a shallow pullback to the moving average, a higher high in price, followed by, yep, that trap low from there, right? Does that sound familiar? Same patterns, just different direction now, right? So again, it's a seller failure. I like to incorporate a support level below the range, right? Seller failure at support below the range, or it's a 1-2-3 breakout, or a 2-try breakout going higher. And you can see kind of what I'm thinking already, right? I've got that trading range. I'd like to get down, right? I'd like to get down and buy below the range at support levels, right? Or go up with that 1-2-3 breakout, mark the high, mark the low, and go from there. Now, the one thing I'm a bit concerned about here is this trend line coming down, right? That trend line is pretty obvious, right? It's pretty obvious, you can see here. In fact, you could say it's a flag, right? You could say it's a flag pattern, right? It's that little bull market up into a channel there. You could say it's a flag too. I'm looking at this as a resistance trend line here. And so what that pretty much tells me to do is I'd like to be a buyer, but I have to be careful, right? Got to be careful here because of that falling resistance trend line. So knowing that, where can I find support below the range, and how can I buy below the range without buying into that, right, into that trend line? Well, here comes one clue. We can mark up the highs off the high of this, right? We can mark the higher highs. We can mark that down for that low. And this creates what's kind of like a spike in channel, right? Spike up, right, into a channel. The only problem with that is clearly that falling resistance. So if I want to buy this trend line, I need to use a trap, basically, one and two. I have to look for a trap entry, right? Basically a bear trap as we pull back to that shallow pullback. Now, this is going to be a pretty aggressive trade, right? And considering the fact that it'll probably happen early in the session before the news comes out, that's a trade that, it's a pretty aggressive trade. What I'd rather get us going back down, ideally into these areas of support down here. If you look left, there's a lot of prior highs, right? Lots of support piling up around that 1904 area. What I'd like to do is still use the same idea of this hidden channel, but now get down to support, get that moving average coming over, get those bears to get short now, and now we're looking at a support level, right? We've got that range acting as a magnet. We know exactly where stop losses are. I now have plenty of space, right, to avoid that falling resistance, and I can now buy into stop losses. The only problem we have is we might not be able to fit that pullback in, right? The pullback might not be easy. Like I mentioned earlier, right, those failure into pullback combinations are very, very common. Failure into pullback combinations off the low of a channel, below the low of a trading range. And again, we talk all about those patterns, right? And a lot more, by the way, inside the free trading classes here. Again, if you haven't done so already, grab that link in the upper right-hand corner, the little information icon there. Grab the little info icon, get registered, right, for our free trading classes that we can learn all these setups. I'll send you hundreds of examples of how we apply these setups to our favorite futures markets. And then don't forget, I'll put all of the important links you guys need down in the description of this YouTube video, right? I'll put membership information down there. I'll put free class information down there. So grab those links in the description of the YouTube video. So going forward here, it's a shallow pullback trap, right? It's a shallow pullback trap. Why? Why trap? Because traps are the most effective ways to avoid, in this case, buying into resistance, okay? Or it's a deeper pullback into, and it really all depends on how much space we have, definitely a failure pattern, right, a seller failure into a bullish pullback, and then the move going higher from there. Again, the pullback pattern is the one variable we got to wait for, because we have to figure out where we are in relationship to that trend line, right, coming down. And then obviously, right, if we try to go higher here, where would we be trying to go, right? If we break out higher, look how much open space there is overhead. Right. Remember, I said earlier, I'm, you know, between you, me, and YouTube, I'm kind of hoping this number comes out dramatically lower tomorrow. I know, please don't hate me out there, but I'm, as a trader, I'm hoping this number comes out lower, because that should kick up gold, right? And that, of course, should also give us some shorts on the oil, right? And on the S&P. Obviously, for the health of the economy, I'm hoping that we get a big, strong number tomorrow, right? For everybody's sake. But as a trader, though, if we can get this number to really collapse tomorrow, we might see this gold here. You know, what's bad for the economy is good for gold, right? We'll have to wait and see what happens, but there's a lot of open space up there. So if the market can grow a pair here, if you will, right? If it can really push higher here, right? If we can get that, if I can zoom back in on this, right? Again, I'm not going to buy high up here, because again, remember, right? It's a big range, right? Where we get a range around here. So I can't buy high on this. What I can do, though, is I can wait for that strong move up. I can wait for that pullback to the moving average. I can wait for the jump off the moving average, right? We call it a 1-2-3 breakout. Mark that high, mark that low, and I can definitely get down with buying that first pullback off the low of that channel. 1-2-3 breakout into hidden channel pullback, or that strong move up, that shallow pullback, right? Shallow pullback, higher high in price, and that trap low. And remember, anytime I look for those patterns, I'm always looking for any other hidden channels that I can use to combine with those entry patterns, right? So if we do get that breakout higher, I will always look for, again, I'll look for, you know, can I draw that trend line like that, right? Obviously, I'm just drawing this stuff up right now, but those are the things I'm looking for tomorrow, combining those entries off the low of those channels as the market runs higher. Don't forget, overnight, careful on gold. If we go sideways here on gold, not a lot changes if the market turns sideways. Let's put it this way. If we go sideways here, that gets rid of that trend line. So it'd almost be a good thing here if we go sideways. Now, I can wait for that pullback. I can wait for that seller to jump in. I can look to buy into stops of those sellers. I can grab seller failures. I can grab pullbacks right on the way back up to retest that high. So it's all about what happens here in the overnight. Do we go sideways? That will negate that trend line. Or do we see a sharp pullback? Look for traps, right? Look for failure patterns down below that low. How do we, right? How do we sell this market? Can I sell this market? I definitely can. There is potential to be a short seller here. There are two patterns I'm watching for right now to be a seller. One of them would be what we call a crown reversal, right? We poke up, right? Poker heads higher here. The buyers come in, try to buy it once. They pull back, try to buy it twice. Crown reversal. Now, why would I look for a reversal in a bull market? Again, that's because of the big range down here. Remember, there's a big range. That's why I started off this section of the video with that big range. That range will want to act as a magnet. Right now, if they have a strong move up and they hold the pullback, okay, now a different story, right? But if we poke our heads higher here, moving average comes over, buyers try once, go lower, buyers try twice now, right? Double top, trap high. We call these crown reversal patterns. That would be a great setup to get short tomorrow, or we can look for the reversal, right? Strong move down, hold the pullback. Right, jump off the moving average and go. 1, 2, 3, reversal into hidden channel pullback. First test, right? First test is always the best test. And again, right, strong move down, shallow pullback, lower low, trap high. That pattern is always on my radar as well. So two try breakouts or two try trap, right? 1, 2, 3 reversal patterns. The bottom line is I've got to get some momentum right now for these bears before I can try to sell this thing, right, as it goes lower. Because we will likely see some buyers coming in there in that 1904, 1905 area. All right, guys, great plan of attack ready for tomorrow. And speaking of tomorrow, don't forget every morning, Monday through Friday, 8 o'clock Eastern time in our trade room. I want to see you there right there with me, guys, every morning to trade this stuff together. I'll put all of the important links you guys need in the description of the YouTube video. Getting registered is super easy. I'll put all the links in the description of the YouTube video, or if you're on the blog right now, hit that big button for me below this video tonight on the trading blog. Don't be afraid to call the office. I'll be standing by to answer all your telephone calls. And if you guys have any questions at all, we can use live support on the left-hand side, the right-hand side. Find that chat button, and I'll be here to answer questions as well. But don't be a stranger, and don't force it tomorrow. Remember, tomorrow morning, non-farm payrolls, possibly the biggest news we get every month. So don't force it. Take it slow and steady. Be disciplined. Remember, small window of opportunity on a Friday morning, early in, early out. And as always, guys, have a great day tomorrow. If we don't see you guys in the trade room every morning, Monday through Friday, I will see you guys on the next edition of our nightly newsletter. My name is Joseph. Be well out there. Be nice to each other, will ya? And be here next time. Adios, amigos. Bye-bye for now.